Hello, welcome to the Spoon Fork Heart Kitchen. สวัสดีค่ะ. My name is Siri. Today, I'm going to show you how to make the butternut squash curry with chicken or แกงฟักทองใส่ไก่Okay, first I'm going to cut our butternut squash. Okay, the easy way to cut. I already clean and then just cut through it, and you're cutting cutting through like this first to be a circle like this. Okay, and then when you cut them to circle like this already, the pieces like this, and then just cut the allow them like this. This is an easy way to cut the butternut squash. Okay, so now one squash, I already peeled everything out, and now we're gonna take the seed out. I'm gonna use my spoon to try to scoop all the seed out. Okay, and our squash is remove all the peel and remove all the seeds. So now I'm going to cut into the bite size. So I end up with the 1 pound and 10 ounce. So I'm going to use it all. Okay. All right. So I'm going to cut to the bite size, and I'm going to cut about this big. And the easy way to cut, just cut them to the strip first, the big chunk first, and then cut into the size that you like. I'm gonna cut them all. Try to cut them to the same size. Okay, now I have one butternut squash, cut it bite size, and I also have the chicken. I use the chicken breast today, cut into the bite size. You can use the chicken thigh. If you prefer the chicken thigh, you can use the chicken thigh. So the butternut squash, 1 pound and 10 ounce, and then the chicken, 1.5 pound. All right, so now we're going to go to the stove and start cooking. All right, so now I turn on the medium heat, and I'm going to add the 1 can the coconut milk. Okay, 1 can coconut milk, and I'm going to cook the coconut milk a little bit until they have the separate with the oil and the coconut milk. Okay, and now the coconut milk start getting boiled, and the oil start getting separate a little bit from the coconut milk. Now I'm going to add the red curry. I used 4 tablespoons red curry, Thai red curry. Okay, and now I'm going to try to mix the red curry and coconut milk, cook together. In Thailand, we do this recipe with the pumpkin, the kabocha squash. So in Thailand, we call pumpkin. So we use the kabocha squash for this recipe. Okay, and I lowering the heat to the low heat, and I keep stir the coconut milk and the red curry. It's about 4 or 5 minutes on the low heat until the coconut milk and the red curry mix well together and give you really, really good smell. And you're gonna see the little bit of oil on top of the coconut milk and the curry. And next, so now you can add on the next ingredient. All right, so I'm going to add my butternut squash all. Okay. Because if you use the chicken thigh, you can add chicken thigh first, or add the chicken thigh first and then add the butternut squash. But today I use the chicken breast. The chicken breast is cooked really fast, and they dry if I cook them too long. So I'm gonna have to add the butternut squash first. Okay, now I'm gonna turn up the heat to medium, and I'm just gonna give them the good mix. Keep the butternut squash and the curry and the coconut milk mix well and cook well together before I can add the next ingredient. All right, so now I'm still in the medium heat, and I mix the butternut squash and the curry and coconut milk. I mix them well together already, and now I'm going to cover, but I'm gonna add a little bit of water, about 3 or 4 tablespoons into it, to make sure my coconut milk and the curry not gonna burn when I cover them. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of water. It's just about 3 or 4 tablespoons, and mix them well again. And now I'm going to give them the cover and for 5 minutes, and I'm gonna come and check. Okay, now being 5 minutes, let's come and check. Okay, and they smell really good right now. I want to make sure the bottom not burn, the coconut milk and the curry not burn, but the squash is still need more time to cook, but I don't want but you have to just come and check every 3 or 5 minutes, so you make sure the curry and the coconut milk not getting burned. Okay, now being about 7 minutes, my squash and the curry cook about 7 minutes. I'm going to taste it. Okay, now it's already, the squash already getting soft, so I don't want them to turn to mushy. So now we can add the next ingredient. All right, still in the medium heat, I'm gonna add another can, the coconut milk. One more can, the coconut milk. Look at how nice and creamy. Take it all out. Every drop, the coconut milk. Wanna creamy. Wow. Alright. And then when you cook the squash and the curry, if you're feeling too dry, you add a little bit of water. Not a lot, add a little bit of water. Okay, and now I'm going to bring to the medium high heat a little bit. And before I add the chicken, I want the curry and the coconut milk to start getting boiled again before I add the chicken. Okay, and now the squash and the coconut milk and the curry, now they start getting come back to boil again. Now time for me to add my chicken. This is the chicken that I cut to the bite size. I'm gonna add them all. For the protein, you can change. You can use beef, you can use pork. It's totally up to you. Or you can use the chicken thigh. It's all up to you. Today, I just picked the chicken breast. Okay, now I'm going to mix the chicken and all the curry mix well together. All right, and then just mix them well together. Make sure they're all separate and give them the time to cook. So I'm going to cover them. It's about like 3 minutes, because chicken breast is cooked really fast, and we come back and seasoning. Okay, we let the chicken cook for 3 minutes, and now time to come back and check. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, the chicken breast is cooked really fast, like I say. Now we can start to seasoning our curry, but before that, let me make sure the they not stick on the bottom. I just want to make sure. Okay, and I just going to use the 2 seasoning for this recipe. So I'm gonna use the fish salt and the sugar. So first I'm going to add the 2.5 tablespoon fish sauce. 2.5 tablespoon. 1, 2, and a little bit more. All right, and I'm gonna give them the mix. Give them the mix, make sure not burn the bottom. The coconut milk and the curry, sometimes they burn to the bottom really easy, so just make sure that. Okay, and when you mix, you have to be gentle mix, because you don't want the squash to broken and get mushy. So not gonna be look good like that. All right, so now fish salt and put it in. Now I'm going to add some sugar. So I'm going to add some, about 1.5 tablespoon the palm sugar. So it's gonna be about this chunk. For I get 1.5 tablespoon, I just have to get, because it's hard to do it with the palm sugar. I just gonna bake them to the small pieces, so they're easy to dissolve. Or if you don't have palm sugar, you can use the coconut sugar, or you can use the brown sugar. Okay, but the brown sugar is going to be a little bit more sweet than the palm sugar. So when you use that, it's just to cut them half. Okay, and now you're making sure the your chicken is done cooking, and the palm sugar is all dissolved, so we can give this our curry a taste. Okay, so I'm gonna give the curry a taste. If you need more salty or if you need more sweet, just add on to this time. But for me, this is already perfect for me, so we can add on the next ingredient. Alright, so like here, the kaffir lam leaf is from my tree. That's why it looks like this. I'm just gonna use about five of them, five or six of them if it's small. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna use 6 of them total. Okay, and I'm gonna use just, I already clean. I'm just gonna use my hand to pat it like this and to the half and put through. Gonna low the heat up a little bit, low the heat a little bit, and I'm going to, okay, continue put my kaffir lam leaf in here. Just use my hand. Just hold the middle pieces of the leaf and then just pull it. They're gonna come easy like this. We don't need the middle part, is it too top, too hard to chew on it? So we just need, so okay, six. All right, so now the kaffir lam leaf in. If you have the sweet pepper, sweet red pepper, you can put it on this time, but I skipped that today. I'm going to put a handful of Thai basil. Handful Thai basil. Okay, it's about 2 cup. Okay, Thai basil, and now I'm going to give them the mix. I have a lot of Thai basil in my garden, in my backyard, so that's why I put in a lot of Thai basil today. All right, and give them the good mix, and they will bring up all the flavor too from the basil, all the herby flavor with the kaffir lam leaf and the Thai basil. Okay, we done. Okay, I turn off the stove right now. After you put the Thai basil, okay, that's the, and give them the mix another minute, and we done. And we just finished with the beautiful, the butternut squash and with chicken curry. Okay, now I can't wait to try our curry. Okay, and then this is the time that I cannot wait. I really, really want to try my butternut squash curry with the chicken and with my rice. Cool, I eat with rice. All right, here I'm gonna slowly so you guys can see it all. Oh, look how creamy. The sweetness from the butternut squash, soon as it touched my mouth, they're soft, they're not too soggy, they're not too. You have to try this recipe. They're creamy. If you like the squash, if you like the curry, you like the Thai curry, this is gonna be easy and perfect for you. Especially this season, have a lot of the squash or pumpkin. Can do with this recipe, quick and easy and delicious. I hope you like this video. I hope you like this recipe. Please give me a thumb up, subscribe, and you will see me for the next recipe. Thank you.